Now we'll look at two examples of solving equations that contain rational exponents. Notice in both cases, the rational exponent is attached to the expression that contains the variable that we're trying to solve for. To solve this type of problem, we're going to use this exponent property here, where if we have powers to powers, we multiply the exponents. So in this first equation here, if we had x plus 4 to the first power, that would just give us x plus 4 on the left. So what we're going to do is raise both sides of the equation to the reciprocal power of 5/3, which would be 3/5. So we have the quantity x plus 4 raised to the 5/3 power equals 32. But now if we raise both sides of the equation to the power of 3/5, which again is a reciprocal of 5/3, notice on the left side we'd have the quantity x plus 4 raised to the 5/3 times 3/5 power, which would just give us the quantity x plus 4 raised to the first equals 32 raised to the 3/5 power. Well, the quantity x plus 4 to the first power is just x plus 4. And now on the right side, to evaluate 32 to the 3/5 power, we'll write this as a radical where the denominator gives us the index and the numerator would be the exponent, where the exponent can be either underneath the radical or outside. So because the denominator is 5, we have the 5th root of 32. Because 32 is a perfect 5th root, we'll go ahead and just raise this to the 3rd power. So we have the quantity x plus 4 equals, the 5th root of 32 is equal to 2, since 2 to the 5th equals 32, and 2 to the 3rd is equal to 8, giving us x plus 4 equals 8. Subtracting 4 on both sides, we have x equals 4. Now looking at our second equation, notice how this 5 is not being raised to the 2/3 power. So our first step is to divide both sides of the equation by 5. So this will give us the quantity 2x minus 1 to the 2/3 power equals 125 divided by 5 equals 25. And now because we want 2x minus 1 raised to the first power, not to the 2/3 power, we'll raise both sides of the equation to the reciprocal power of 2/3, which would be 3/2. So now we have the quantity 2x minus 1 raised to the power of 2/3 times 3/2, that would be 6/6, or just 1. On the right side we have 25 raised to the 3/2 power. The quantity 2x minus 1 to the first is just 2x minus 1 equals, to evaluate 25 to the 3/2 power, since the denominator is 2, this would be the square root of 25, and since the numerator is 3, this would be cubed. So we have 2x minus 1 equals, the square root of 25 is 5, 5 cubed equals 125. And now to solve for x, we add 1 to both sides. That would give us 2x equals 126. Divide both sides by 2. Our solution is x equals 63. I hope you found this helpful.